Hey everyone, thanks for watching the replay. Welcome to this week's edition of Brad's Live. I'm Brad and I am so glad you're here. We are broadcasting live today from a snowy Denver, Colorado, but don't fret. They say it's going to be 62 degrees tomorrow, so if we get a little accumulation, it will be gone. As always, Brad's Live is brought to you by the Friedman Group, LLC, your inbound email and social media marketing partner. As you know, we work with professionals in regulated industries and business owners who want to have a professional image online and want to take advantage of the power of the internet and do it like a pro. I am so excited about the show today. We have a great guest. I am going to be bringing out Stephanie Liu. Yes, world famous, world renowned, international rock star, live video guru. I don't know. The descriptive words for Stephanie would take up the whole hour of the show. But I do want to tell you a little bit about Stephanie, because we're going to be talking about how to use Facebook Live to grow your business. But Stephanie, geez, let's talk about her for a second. She's an online marketing strategist, live video trainer, self-proclaimed 90s beat scholar. And yeah, we're going to talk about that right off the bat. I sort of warned her about this. She's been implementing the psychology of human behavior in the advertising industry for more than a decade. And one of the things that Stephanie and I have in common is that we both love data. We like looking at the data and making data-driven decisions. That's something I think is very important. And if you know me, you know I think that's very important. And that's one of the things Stephanie and I have in common. She led paid search advertising for one of the largest search engines in the United States, served as the director of social strategy for San Diego's leading ad agency, and she's created powerful campaigns for small businesses to giant multi-million dollar corporations. Stephanie is speaking next March at Social Media Marketing World 2019 in San Diego, and that is where I hope to meet Stephanie live and in person, because it's an awesome conference, and I've already got my ticket. Had it for months. Okay, as the host of Lights, Camera, Live, Stephanie shines a spotlight on the best and brightest marketers in the industry, and she has a course, Lights, Camera, Live, which is the only online interactive course that teaches you how to turn your ideas, skills, and experience into a captivating live stream. All right, I could go on, and I actually have a little more written here, but enough is enough. Let's get down to the action here. I'm going to bring her in right now so we can talk about being a 90s beat bot.
Beat scholar. Beat yes. Scholar.
All right. Yes. What's up with that? Hi, Stephanie.
Hey. Hey, Brad. Hey, what's up, everyone? How are you doing? Beat scholar. Anything 90s related, you'll see me as the official party starter out on the floor. That's for sure.
Okay.
So come Social Media Marketing World 2019. That's where you'll find me.
You'll be on the midway in the party dancing on the floor. That's where I'll find you.
That's for sure.
Okay. All right. Anything I left out of that intro you want people to know about you?
No, you nailed it. You got like every single thing. And I love that, because most people will just like grab the little snippets, but you went all out. Love it. You're the ultimate hype man.
Yes. Oh, I like to do my research. I like to know who I'm talking to in advance.
That's good.
So tell me a little bit about your backstory and how you got to be this live video guru.
Oh, that's so funny. Okay, so when I used to work at the agency, I spent like probably like a decade and a half working in the agency world, right? Doing social media for all the big brand names. Some of them you might know, Nike, Sephora, Clinique. I don't know.
I heard of a few of those, yeah.
Kind of, maybe. And what had happened was my husband and I were expecting a baby. And then it was at that point, Brad, where I realized, oh gosh, like I can't be working 50 plus hours a week and, you know, raise a human being. So at that point, it's like, all right, cool. I'm going to go ahead and start my own thing, right? If I could pitch in front of these big brands, I'm sure as heck, I know I could do it for myself, right? So I left the agency world, launched my own boutique agency, and come to realize like everyone was calling themselves a social media strategist. And I was like, what? Like you worked with these brands too, or you've done this? And it was one of those things where it's like, well, how do I separate myself from the sea of sameness? And what I realized was that everyone else was comfortable copying and pasting stuff to, you know, schedule on social media, but no one was really willing to step into the spotlight and say like, hey, this is who I am. This is what I do. And let me show you how. And so that's when I stepped into doing live video because I was like, cool, I could show you. I don't always have to be on the screen. I could like screencast and mm-hmm. I could show you my broadcasting plan, my editorial calendars and whatnot. And that started to like win me some clients. And it was amazing. But what really kind of set it off was the fact that my first client for live video was MasterChef Claudia Sandoval. Like she was always a friend of mine in the agency world. Like she was like the head honcho of Instagrammer San Diego. She would lead like the Instagram meetups. Then one day she decided, hey, I'm going to apply for MasterChef. A couple months later, she won the whole thing. And then she needed someone to help her out with live video. And because she saw me doing lights, camera, live, she's like, I want you to help me right now because I have this cool thing that's happening. And then ever since then, it's just taken off.
Wow, that is awesome. How fun. That is a fun way to sort of get started.
Yeah, and it's weird because I never really tried to position myself as the live video marketing expert. It just turned out that because when I'm really interested in something, I get really geeky about it. Like day and night, I will read about it. I'll hang out in forums, which is probably like very antiquated for some people. They're like forums, like yes, like Reddit forums and checking out YouTube channels to figure out how things work. And once you practice with live video and you figure out all the different hacks, you eventually become the expert because you've failed so many times. Right. You failed so many times. Like you can know like what could possibly go wrong. So like when you and I were in the lobby room and we were chatting about like what just went wrong, I was like, dude, been there, done that. Let's roll with it.
Yeah. I think much of my online life is just one big long blooper reel.
You know, sometimes in life when I mess up, I'm like, control Z, can I undo that? But you can't, you know, so you're just right. Like, yes, and roll right. With it.
And then afterwards you have to think, should I delete it or should I leave it? I once had a podcast. Well, I had a Facebook Live where there was 8 minutes of this like noise in the background and I could not figure out what it was. And eventually I did figure out what it was. And it was, of course, my fault because I had another window open and the sound on. So it was giving us all this feedback. So I'm thinking, yeah. So what do I do with this? It's the first 8 minutes. And I put it up and then I created a podcast. And I said at the beginning of the podcast, you can skip ahead 8 minutes or you could just enjoy the fact that I messed up for the first 8 minutes and, you know, just laugh at. And I figured, here's a perfect example of what live video is really all about because you never know. Yeah. You never know what's going to happen.
And I mean, I've had my bloopers too. I had this one time when I had a guest on the show and every time he would talk, like a hidden video that I had in one of my OBS layers would play the audio for another interview that I had. So it sounded like we had like a ghost on the broadcast, which is like perfect for this, right? Because it's Halloween. But it was like really spooky because I would hear him, but I wouldn't hear like this voice that was happening in the background. And all of the viewers were like, what is that? Like they were kind of freaked out because they're like, who is this other woman's voice that's happening? And eventually it got to the point where everyone was talking about it. And I was like, you know, let's just redo it. You know, let's just redo it. Because now it was kind of like our first tech rehearsal. I was like, that'll be our tech rehearsal, and then we'll do it again. So
sweet. Sweet. All right. So let's talk. Let's talk Facebook Live. Yes. Why should business owners today be using Facebook Live?
Okay. Well, one of the great things about Facebook is the fact that there are more than, I think it's like 2 billion people. that are on Facebook right now.
Yeah.
So if you're thinking about your target audiences, I'm pretty sure they fall within that 2 billion person category, right? But the other thing is that, like, Mike Stelzner had talked about this on Social Media Examiner about how there's this whole algorithm apocalypse. People aren't seeing their post in the newsfeed anymore. And I always make this joke where it's like, if you wanted to post like a photo or a link, it's like winking in the dark and expecting someone to see you. It's not going to happen these days, right? Like, it just, it might not happen as much versus if you actually went ahead and used live video, because Facebook is really pushing for live video. They know that that live video is going to drive more engagement and more interactions. And if they could keep more eyeballs on the site, why not? So as a matter of fact, like, let's keep people engaged right now. If you guys are tuning in, let us know where you're watching from, right? Because I'm here in San Diego, 72 and sunny, right? Brad, you're in Denver. You said it was snowing.
I'm in Denver where it's 36 and snowing. Yeah.
I can't even imagine. Yes,
where's everybody else watching from?
Where are you
watching on the replay? Tell us where you're watching from too.
Exactly. But yeah, so if you ever wanted to go ahead and step out of the sea of sameness and really start building a relationship with your audience, live video is one of the best ways to do that because you have a production studio in the palm of your hand. Not many of you are walking around these days without your smartphone in your hand. So now, just with the power of that, you could go ahead and promote your product, your service, be a person of value, and do that all through Facebook. You know, and then if you wanted to geek out a little bit more, which I always do, is go ahead and leverage Facebook ads to retarget people that might be interested in your services.
Oh, yeah, that's great. So you mentioned this algorithm apocalypse, and I heard something yesterday for the first time that I'm not sure is true or is a myth, but this person was telling me that because there's so much challenge you getting organic reach, that now it's not even worth going live if you don't have at least 1500 people who like your page, or if you're going on your personal profile, 1500 people who are your friends on your personal profile. And to be honest, I had never heard that number before. Truth or myth?
I would say myth for now. I feel like that's more of a scare tactic, right? Because live video is just, it's a tactic, right? But if you have a pre-promotional strategy to get people to tune in the time that you actually go live, or you have some type of distribution plan after you go live, you could always get the views and the engagement there. So I don't necessarily see that as, I don't know, I don't think like Facebook is completely dead, to be honest.
Yeah.
There's so much you could do. Yeah.
I mean, I was like, oh, okay, well, I haven't heard that, but I might look into it because, I mean, maybe if that's the magic number, I don't know. I just thought it was.
Yeah. I mean, like let's, okay. So I'll give you a perfect example because I like to put things in like concrete terms. Like, one of my clients is the National Conflict Resolution Center. We talk about how you can resolve conflict with civility, right? So this is like mediation, communication skills. We only had about like 843 fans of our Facebook page, but earlier this year, we had our whole Peacemaker Awards gala, right? We went ahead and we went live. We had like more than 900 people join us live to watch that broadcast, right? We had like $1 million donated to our cause, and that live broadcast definitely helped us out with that. So it's just one of those things where I'm like, I don't think you necessarily need to have 1,500 people. If you have like a really well thought out strategy and promotional plan for before, during, and after, you can get the engagement that you really want.
So let's talk about that. Let's talk about getting the engagement that you want.
Yeah.
How do we go about doing that?
Okay. Well, so you started to do this, and I love that you did this, is that I usually create a Facebook event before I actually go live. Because I want to tease it out. I want to get people super interested in what it is that I'm going to go ahead and cover in my Facebook Live, right? So I'll drop in my description of the Facebook event, the why, the what, the how, the what if, right? Like, this is why you need to tune in to today's episode. This is what we're going to talk about. This is how we're going to walk you through it. And what happens if you don't follow our advice? You know, right? Like, you might actually just become like the Blockbuster of your industry versus the Netflix.
Oh,
so. No. I know, right? So I'll put that in the event. And then I'm very strategic. I'll invite people that I know that would be really, really interested in it. Maybe it's someone in my Facebook group that has asked me about Instagram Live before, or someone has asked me about email before, right? Like I could go ahead and invite them to that specific episode. That event, I'll share it into groups. I get people buzzing about it. You even did this where you started posting into the group of, or posting in, into the event to ask people, like, if you have any live video questions right now, go ahead and drop them here, and then I'll ask Stephanie on the air. I do that all the time with folks. Then once I actually go live, you kind of saw me do it even here. It's like, if you guys are tuning in, go ahead and let me know where you're watching from. It's the easiest thing to do. It's the easiest icebreaker, right? Like all you have to say is like Seattle, Florida, you know, Guam, something that's super easy. It's not something super hard, but it's an easy icebreaker because as you start to have this conversation with your fans, they realize like, okay, like this is how I engage with Stephanie and Brad. I could go ahead and leave a comment and they'll go ahead and respond back to me. Other things to do in terms of like driving engagement, like, listen, you guys, if you've been interested in live video and you, or you know someone that's been talking about like, hey, I'm going to launch that live video show, but they haven't done it yet, tag them right now in the comments and say like, this is the episode. Stephanie is your Facebook live video hype queen. I will get you excited about live video. Right. And you just keep doing that. You just keep telling people like, this is what we're talking about, the why, the what, the how, the what if. Invite other people, answer questions on air if you can. If you're one of the types where you're like, oh my God, I'm thinking about audio, I'm thinking about video, I'm thinking about comments, you know, like how am I going to do all of that, you know, and still respond to questions on air? The thing that I'll always tell people to do is give yourself permission. Like if I was Brad, I'd be like, hey, you guys, you know, we've covered a lot so far right now. So I'm just going to go ahead and take a look at the comments and see if there's any questions that I missed. And then that gives you permission to stop trying to multitask everything. Like you can now finally look at the comments and be like, okay, here's a bomb question that I want to go ahead and answer on air. And that's awesome.
Right.
After the show, it's repurposing that content. Honestly, if you could splice and dice it. And I laugh whenever I say splice and dice, because it reminds me of Mike Alton. I had him on the show once and he's like, with blogging, you can splice and dice. And now I picked it up from him, but you could totally repurpose your live video. You know, you can make it into an Instagram story short, put it into Instagram TV, YouTube, pull out some quotes, turn it into a blog post. As far as engagement goes, engage with any of the questions that you didn't have time to answer on the air. And I mean, you heard this in the podcast when I was talking to Mike Stelzner, I'm very strategic about it. Like if Brad left me like 5 comments, I will probably answer his top priority question first. And then maybe a day later, if he just says, hey, I'm tuning in from Denver, I'd be like, oh yeah, I remember the last time I was in Denver was like 2010. It's been a while, right? But every time I respond to Brad's comment, if I space it out, at least I'm popping back up into his newsfeed. So now we're re-engaging again, right?
Right.
The other way to engage people is going back to the events. Right. I've been live streaming for 2 years now, right? It feels like forever. And what's cool is that for every single event, it's around a specific topic. So if it's about Instagram Live, right? And I know that I'm doing, you know, a live stream tomorrow about Instagram Live, I could go back to the first event and say like, hey, if you're interested in this hack, you might actually be interested in tomorrow's episode. So now I've kind of segmented my audience without even thinking about it. Right. It was just kind of like, oh,
yeah,
you watch that first one. Go ahead and watch this new one that I have because it's going to be updated. All of the social media platforms are always going to be updated. Right. So I could even go back into the event and say like, OK, here's the blog recap of Brad and I, drop it back into the Facebook event. And I'm just going. I never let the comments die.
Right. So do you ever put money into promoting a Facebook Live broadcast?
Honestly, no, it's not all the time. If I'm ever promoting a Facebook Live broadcast, it's probably because I want to get my broadcast in front of a certain person. And so this is kind of like the little hack I was telling other people before, was that if I wanted to speak at a conference, I would target people that worked at that conference, because then they would see like, oh, Brad gets so much engagement on his Facebook Live videos, he'd probably be a really great speaker for this event. And then you get the email where it says like, hey, Brad, we'd love to have you at the event. You're like, oh, I wonder how I became top of mind, tip of tongue. Maybe it's because they kept seeing me, right?
Right. Oh, that's great. That's great. And what about promoting it on like other social networks, Twitter, LinkedIn, even?
It is a little helpful because some people that are connected to me on LinkedIn, you know, from my agency days, aren't friends with me on Facebook or just aren't aware of my Facebook business page. So a lot of what I'll do is I'll go ahead and just create like a little teaser of like where I'm dropping like the best tip, right? It's like, here's the top tip, but you're only going to get one because if you want the rest, then you have to go and hang out with Brad and Steph over on Facebook.
Ah, there you go. That seems to sound like something that would really work. How about these chatbots?
Oh, I love the chatbots. only because I only use it for one thing. Like some people go like above and beyond, right? But I only use it for one thing, and that's really to let my viewers know if Lights, Camera, Live when I'm on air. Because that's the only thing that I ask them. I was like, if you want to be notified when I'm on air, go ahead and leave the comment, subscribe on this post. And then when I do that, what's nice is that as soon as I hit the go live button, right? And I also schedule my RoboStuff is the name of my bot, right? RoboStuff will tell the Lights, Camera, Live crew like, hey, Stephanie is live right now. Go ahead and tune in. And as soon as it happens, it's nice because I'm not staring at like the total number of viewers being zero, right? Like maybe there's like 5, 10 that are going to go ahead and trickle in. But I could work with that because then at least I feel like I'm engaging with someone versus pretending to talk to someone when no one's there.
Well, that's great. And part of the reason that I asked that question is because it leads to a wonderful segue where I can remind people about the new Brad bot. And if you type live in the comments below, you'll get a little reminder right before we go live next time too. That's what I've been using my bot for, but it's challenging to get people to subscribe to the bot. So what advice do you have for getting people to subscribe to your bot?
I have it done several ways. So like, let's say for tomorrow's broadcast, I already have the pre-scheduled broadcast and then I have in my copy, like leave the comment, subscribe to get a notification. So that's one way. The other way is when I have the blog recap. On the blog recap, I have the embedded video, and then there's a little button that says subscribe notifications via Facebook Messenger bot. So sometimes I have people coming to the site, maybe they'll see the actual video, and then they'll go ahead and click that button. That's actually the fun button, PS, by the way, because if you click that button, you will see a happy dance from RoboSeph.
That's like, that's RoboSeph. Hey, Eddie Garrison, how you doing today?
Eddie Garrison!
Thanks for joining us.
Yeah.
Yeah, so I think those chatbots are great. They can be annoying if they're not done properly, and you're getting messages all the time. But I think it's a great way to give people a reminder right before, and if you use it judiciously, you won't get people too angry at you. What about cross posting?
Ooh, cross posting is fun. So I did this for, so there's two ways to cross post. Like, I love that you're asking this question because I'm going to geek out with you. There's two ways to cross post. The one is just video cross posting. So any videos that you already have on your Facebook page, you could allow other pages to cross post it on theirs. And it's going to look like it's their original content, but any engagement that happens on their pages is going to roll up to yours. So that was kind of like what I was doing before. I have a couple of influencers or just super sharers in my group that said, Stephanie, I love your stuff. And if I could just reshare it, is that okay? And I was like, yeah, totally. Absolutely. So I gave them cross-posting access. And what was really cool was that as soon as they shared it, it already had social proof, meaning as soon as like Ross Brand from Livestream Universe shared it, it already showed that his video had 4,000 views. So that gets people thinking. It's a psychological trigger of, okay, people are already watching this. They're tuning in. I should probably go ahead and listen to it as well. So from like a building your audience perspective, it was brilliant because however fans he has on his page, they are now watching content that's from my page. And for me, as a live streamer who's always looking for like brand sponsors, I could go ahead and put in my media kit that I have this huge distribution strategy, this amount of viewers, because I'm taking advantage of cross-posting. So that was like the first time that cross-posting ever came out. Was it was usually just for your videos, but now you could do live cross-posting. And this is the one where I'm like, you guys, this is an opportunity for you to do like a blitz campaign, right? Like, let's say you're going to be launching your course, your podcast, anything. And if you just want like, boom, everyone knows about it, you connect all these different pages. As soon as you go live, you're going live on your page, my page, five other people's pages, and people are scrolling through their newsfeed and they're like, what is going on? This is breaking news, right? So that's like cross-posting capabilities. And I haven't done the live cross-posting on other pages before. There's a couple of brands that want to test it out. So we'll see. We'll see.
So when you're cross-posting, if we were cross-posting, say, to your page today, and somebody's watching on your page, mm-hmm. if they leave a comment, do we see it? Or do we have to be watching the video from your page in order to see the comment?
Yeah. So that's the drawback. That's the drawback. And I'm like, Facebook, come on. Like, this is such a cool feature. But you could have gone like all the way to like, you know, like really think about it. But that's a good point. If there's any comments that's happening on any other of the other pages that are being live cross-posted, the comments are going to stay there. You're not going to see it unless you actively look at all the other pages. So like, let's say you connected five other pages. Comments are coming in everywhere. It's not going to be helpful. So right. The strategic thing to do is in your caption to say like, click on the original video or click on this page to participate in the live comments. And then that'll get people pumped up.
Right. Right. Okay. So we talked a little bit about some of the statistics about Facebook and why business owners ought to be using live video in order to grow their business. A lot of times I hear from business owners, okay, I buy into the concept, mm-hmm. but to be honest with you, I don't have anything to say.
Oh, stop.
For like 10 seconds, but every week or every month even. So let's talk a little bit about appropriate content.
Sure. Okay. So there's this formula that I always teach everyone. It's called the 10 by 10 formula in 10 minutes. Right. So it's literally you get a piece of paper. I just have like a notebook on my desk, but like you get a piece of paper, you fold it in half. On one side, you're going to get the top 10 frequently asked questions about your business, your product, or your service, and just start jotting them down. For something like live video, people will always ask me things like, what camera are you using? What mic are you using? What social media live streaming platform? Yada, yada, yada. And then on the right-hand side, you want to go ahead and put top 10 questions people should be asking you, but they don't know because they're not the expert in that field, right? So for example, you do email, right? You do email right. for clients. That way they could go ahead and be pros. One of the things that they should be asking is, you know, how am I going to grow my email list versus how many times should I email a day, right? So just kind of like,
yeah.
If you do that, right, if you do that in 10 minutes, and honestly, you could check through your emails. You could go on sites like Quora about like your specific topic, your niche, right? You could type in a Google search for that specific topic. And I'm sure you're going to find 10 topics under frequently asked questions or should ask questions. And by the time that 10 minutes is up, you've got 20 ideas, right? You've got 20 ideas. And if you wanted to just do a minute live broadcast, you absolutely can. I mean, I have one client where we do Mindset Mondays, and all we talk about is how to reset your brain for the work week. That way, you're much calmer in the workplace versus feeling super stressful. But we've been doing that for like almost a year now, and we've started to build an audience that way. And, you know, it's up to you if you want to go live every single week or every month. It's up to you on how you want to pan it out. I mean, I honestly go live twice a month, but because I was on vacation, like the last month, I probably went live once, but I still got the engagement from my audience because they're following me on other social media channels to know what else I'm doing.
So when you talk to a client about scheduling, is it whatever you're comfortable with? Is there data on how many times a month you need to go live in order to really get traction?
I don't think there's really much data in terms of like, you need to go live X amount of times a month to generate XYZ revenue. If anything, it really boils down to the first video. So like, the first time you ever went live, what are some stats that we could go ahead and take a look at? What was the engagement? What was the organic reach? What can we do to go ahead and generate some buzz before, during, and after? Like, that's always going to be super helpful. What are some things that are happening in the comments where we could get some qualitative data in terms of like, hey, you know, they kept asking about this question. Maybe that should be the topic for the next live video. And then we could expand on it a little bit more. For most clients, live video right now is kind of like a once in a blue moon, we'll go ahead and do it, right? Like none of specific clients are just kind of, we'll do it when we have time, but it's not set in their schedules yet. If anything, I'm probably the one that's like, okay, I'm going to go live at least twice a month. But someone like Eddie Garrison, so like shout out to Eddie, he goes live twice a week, like Mondays and Fridays. And I was like, I don't even know how much time you have to do that. Like the only reason why I go live twice a month is because I spend a lot of time and effort in promoting one episode, right? Like I spent a lot of effort in generating buzz before it. And after that episode has aired, I don't want to bury it with another episode. Like I want to keep getting the mileage out of that content that I had planned for, that I had scheduled, or for the guests that I had, instead of burying them down for like another post about XYZ.
Right. Right. And Eddie says, I work with a few bars that do lives every Monday to announce the specialty drink of the week. Quick intro, then a bartender makes the drink, done in 3 minutes.
That's awesome. Yeah.
Yeah. That's awesome. I think that is.
Awesome. And like, so even now.
Oh, sorry. Quick shout out to Mike Alton, who I hope is still with us. you know, Mike loves cross posting from his comment.
Mike is the best.
So can you use these? Can you do live video broadcast and take advantage of the Facebook watch parties?
Yeah. So if you wanted to go ahead and do watch parties in a Facebook group, you could absolutely do that. You could create like a watch list of certain episodes. So if you were doing, and this goes back to your other question about what kind of things you could talk about on a live video, you could talk about episodic content. So if you're building from one idea to another and you're layering it, right? Like how to launch a podcast, step one, do this, step two, yada, yada. You could then create like a playlist for a watch party in your Facebook group. So you could do that. So a watch party is different from Facebook watch where they have like the shows now that's happening.
Right, right, right. Okay. All right. So we've talked a little bit about the why. We've talked a little bit about the content. So let's say that we have the business owner who has actually bought in and they're going to do it and they do their first one. So what do they do afterwards?
What do they do afterwards to optimize it?
Yeah. What do you do to take advantage of that painful minute or 30 minutes where you were struggling to find something to say? So how do I get some mileage out of it?
Okay. Well, and it's funny too, because it really depends on how you're working with your clients, because usually I just need my client just to be in front of the camera. And then once they're done, they could go back to their day. And then I'm the one that's optimizing it. So after you're done with your live stream, go ahead and go back to the comments. Engage with the people. That's going to be super helpful. If you can, go ahead and get a transcript for your Facebook Live video. My favorite hack is to download the Facebook Live video, upload it over to YouTube, download the SRT file, and then upload that back into Facebook. Because we all know that most people, when they're watching video on Facebook, they're usually watching with the sound off, right?
Right.
So that's one way you could do it. Take that same transcript, turn it into a blog post. Now you have a blog post that can connect back to your Facebook video. You could pin the content. You could put it on social media. Maybe you want to do something extra special and like put it on LinkedIn Pulse as a new article. Ah. Yeah, there's so much you could do. So much you could do.
Yeah. So, Mike, the reason why I have a smile on my face is Mike Alton's recent comment, "Hey, Brad, always try to catch stuff when she's preaching."
Yes. You know, live video is just one of those things now where, honestly, Brad, I don't have to worry about any other social media platform. As a boutique social media agency owner, I was like, oh crap, okay. Because I do social media, I should be on Instagram, I should be on Twitter, I should be on LinkedIn. And just the thought of handling all that, plus my clients, plus my three-nager, just felt like, oh my God, my head is going to explode, right? But with live video, I only had to focus on going live twice a month, and then that was it. Twice a month, that's it. As soon as I'm done going live, without a doubt, I will get a message in my inbox that says, hey, Stephanie, are you looking for a new client? Or can you help me with XYZ? And I could either, send them to a friend that could do a full service social media retainer, or I could send them to a course. There's, it's just live video is a moneymaker for me. It pays the bills.
So Eddie says, upcycling your live streams give you so many options to generate other content for your social media channels. And that's what you were really talking about there for a minute. And absolutely,
Yeah.
I think that's absolutely right.
Well, what are
Absolutely.
you doing right now? What are you doing with your live videos?
So I am uploading them to YouTube. I'm putting them on my website. I am stripping the audio from them and turning them into podcasts.
Brilliant.
And pretty much, yeah, I think that's pretty much what I'm doing with them.
That's awesome.
Yeah, I mean, I try to get as much mileage out of it as I can because, like you said, it's time consuming. I mean, it's time consuming to set it up. It's time consuming to promote it. It's time consuming, to research your guest and do it. And, I just think that for at least for the business owners that I work with today, there really isn't a better option
Oh,
for
yeah.
developing thought leadership, trust, credibility, doing all the things you need to do in the world today to get people to engage your services or buy your product.
Very true. Very true. And I think video just helps you resonate and build rapport with your audiences a lot faster because they get to know you about being able to see someone on camera and see them smile and be like, okay, cool. Like, I could see myself having a conversation with Brad, telling him about my problem, and then him walking me through how to solve it. Right?
Right.
Like that is going to resonate a lot deeper with me versus here's my process on my website and here's a flow chart.
Yeah, that usually doesn't go over as well. And I think, I mean, it's the same thing, in a different way. I do a lot of work with clients on LinkedIn because of the nature of the work that they do. And I'm always telling them, hey, if your profile doesn't have a photo, I mean, people want to see you. They want to see who it is that they're doing business with. Live video is just another way of showing people who you are and what you're about and giving them a little taste of your personality.
Yeah. It was funny because I was speaking at a conference and someone was saying like, what if people watch your video and they don't want to work with you because they don't like your style? And it's like, well, then why would you want to work with that person? Like if you can't be yourself and you have to be a little bit more rigid, right? Is that fun for you? There's a reason why I got out of the agency world because I was tired of like kissing butt. So it's just, your video, you're going to attract your tribe with your personality and people are going to realize like, yes, I want to work with that person. If someone is looking for someone that is more prim and proper and cool. That's just not like for me, that's not me. I talk fast, I move my hands.
I mean, and I think that's one of the reasons why I stopped practicing law when I stopped practicing law was that I had to not be me for so much of the time. I
Oh,
mean, when you're in court and you're having to be serious, and every once in a while I would let something slip and it would be like, oh, the real me just came out for a second. I just got a very nasty look from that judge.
oh gosh. I have this one conversation with Professor Nez. He has his own podcast too, but I call it like the business. Like there's like the business voice, that personality. And I was like, no, I'm just gonna be me. you know? Yeah. And I think also when you do live video, when you're talking about a particular topic, you're going to see the passion come through a lot easier than you would sometimes reading the text on a page, right? Yeah. Like I could talk to you and geek out about live video or email marketing and just be super gung-ho about it. If you were to talk to me about blogging, no, you talk to Mike Alton about that.
Yeah, I think I saw you with Mike once and you were talking about how much you dislike
I do. Blog post. I do. So he's your guy. He's my guy. Yeah, and he's funny because he will literally message me after a live video and be like, Stephanie, just in that 5 minutes, you have 10 potential blog posts. And I'm like, I do? He's like, yeah. And he'll bullet it out. I'm like, okay, I'll try to figure that out. But again, that's why it's so nice to take your live videos and the transcripts and turn it into something else. Like even this, I'll probably go to rev.com, turn it into a transcript and be like, what can I talk? Like what can be a blog post?
Yeah, well, I think with the value bombs you've dropped so far that there's at least five, maybe six blog posts so far. So what is this new Facebook Premiere?
Oh, okay. Facebook Premiere is amazing, especially for, okay, listen, for those of you that want the benefits of live video but are uncomfortable being live right then and there, Premiere gives you the option to take pre-recorded videos and then publish them as if they were a live video. So instead of having the live badge, you'll have the Premiere badge. People can go ahead and leave comments as soon as it airs. People can go ahead and get a notification to be notified as soon as it does air. And so it has all those benefits of a live video, but you have permission to do a pre-recorded. So we've been doing this for one of my clients, same one that I mentioned before, National Conflict Resolution Center. October is National Bullying Prevention Month. And so we planned out every single Monday, we're going to give parents, employers, families tips on how they could prevent bullying at school, at home, and at work, right? And so we have every Monday video pre-scheduled as a premiere. And now people are clicking to get notified of when it's going to air. So we have like the first, I think there's like five Mondays in October, but the first four videos are going to be premiere videos. And then the fifth video is going to be a Facebook Live where we're going to recap the first four videos. So it becomes like this whole entire like content series. And I never would have thought of that idea as like creating a content cluster until Premiere happened. Because I was like, you know what? Instead of just randomly thinking of Mindset Monday videos, let's theme them every month now. Because if we could always end the last Monday as a live video, then that would be cool.
Oh, nice. Nice. So we have the Facebook Live producer, Facebook Premiere. What do you know about the live producer, the features?
Okay. The Facebook Live producer looks like OBS. And I don't know if you guys have ever played around with OBS Studio before, but basically you can build your live show the way that you want it to look like. If you want it to be a split screen, if you wanted to have picture in picture, or if you wanted to have text overlays, you could create different scenes. So like even for me, when I use Lights, Camera, Live, I have probably like four different scenes set up. I have my intro video. I have me as a solo. I have me and my guests. And then I have my desktop. And then I have screenshots. So I have like five different scenes on mine. You could create that on Facebook Live Producer. They haven't fully rolled it out yet. Like I played around with it. I was able to go ahead and drop in my images, but for oddly enough, I can't connect my camera. So I'm like, okay, this is obviously still in beta, right? Cause I was emailing the guy and I was like, hey, like, thank you for the beta access. I was able to get all this hooked up, but for some weird reason, I can't get my video hooked up, and that's kind of important. So we'll see what happens. Like the rumor was that it was going to launch like the month that like Vid Summit was going to happen, and like Vid Summit is happening right now. So who knows, maybe, but I did check today and I was like, I still can't connect my camera. So I was like, whatever.
Wow. You'd think that that would be like the number one thing that they enable.
Yeah. I messaged him. I even created like a Loom video. I don't know if you've heard about Loom. Loom is like, yeah. You record your screen. I was like, this is what I'm doing. It should be as simple as clicking this and then my video shows. So I don't know why it's not working.
So, wow. So Eddie Garrison says, doesn't Premiere also allow engagement live as a live video but it is pre-recorded, meaning comments come in live and you can respond in real time.
That's right. Yeah. So they feel like as, and the best way for me to describe it is, okay, do you guys remember MTV? Do you remember when there was like Total Request Live? And I'm totally going to date myself, but whatever. When Britney Spears was going to like drop like her like new album, it was this big, huge thing as the world premiere, right? So that's kind of how I view premiere as on Facebook. Like you're going to drop the bomb. It's going to be a big, huge announcement. You're generating this pre-buzz to get people talking about it. And then as soon as it airs, right? Like, oh my God, what is Britney wearing? I'm like laughing at myself in my head right now. It's like, oh, I love that, right? They're engaging in real time and it makes it a ton of fun. So that's how I envision a premiere.
Okay, that makes sense. I get that. And yeah, I actually remember MTV. And I even know who Britney Spears is.
Thank you. Thank you.
As a matter of fact, just to make you feel a little better, not too long ago, a couple years ago, went with my daughter and my son and the family to Las Vegas to celebrate my daughter's birthday. And mm-hmm. I forced, and I'm telling you, it was forced, everybody to go see Britney Spears.
Yes.
I got to tell you, it was a little disappointing. I
think
she had a little off night. Didn't look like she was actually singing while she was dancing. Many times she wasn't even moving her lips to pretend like she was singing because we were close enough that we could see that. But it was a fabulous production. And even though I got a lot of grief for it for the next day or two, I think it was worthwhile.
That's good.
Yeah. So any tips, tricks on how to stay organized to do all these things that we've talked about, creating the event, adding comments, changing your post, cross-posting, coming up with your content, inviting a guest, all the things that go into this. How do you stay organized?
I use a project management tool. So I use Asana, ASANA.com, and it's free. And so I just how does 25-year-old remember? That's how I threw me off. Eddie, oh my God, love you.
I thought it was going to say Brad instead of Steph there, but I know, right? Maybe, seriously. Maybe not. Maybe I'm past that 25.
I am so red. Brad killed me. Anyways, Asana, I have a template. Let me go through it.
No way. You can't just skip over it. That's an important question. Just because Eddie wasn't here at the very beginning when we were talking you about you being a 90s beat scholar.
I know, right? Oh my gosh. So Asana, I have like this whole process doc. Like it's like a standard office procedures in terms of how I'm going to promote a show. And fortunately for me, I have an intern who goes to UC San Diego, does a fantastic job in terms of helping me write the copy, promote the show, yada, yada, yada. And now it's a system that I have. I never feel like I'm grasping for straws. And the funny thing too, Brad, is that because I've been live streaming for 2 years, I've created events over the last 2 years, summaries, yada, yada. People aren't going to know if you took the same event copy from Instagram one and then just swapped out a couple of words, couple of names, right? And then just put it for Instagram two. They are not going to remember that because what they remember most is like seeing you on camera, not the Facebook event. So I just have a template. It's like Mad Libs style. There, another one for you. Another one for you, Eddie Garrison, Mad Libs.
He's Googling that right now.
I know. He's like, how does she know Mad Libs?
So you just mentioned Instagram and then you mentioned it a little earlier that you're doing something about Instagram tomorrow. What is that?
Oh, okay. This is so much fun. I'm not a live streamer on Instagram. And the reason why is because to me, the phone is just way too small. Like I like looking at my DSLR. There's just something about having like more space, right? And so tomorrow's Facebook Live is about how you can do an Instagram Live from your desktop. So that means I could connect my DSLR that I have now, and I could go ahead and I could still see the comments that are happening on the screen. I could see my most engaged users. But not only that, though, like this live streaming platform lets me go live on Instagram, on YouTube, on other live streaming platforms like TikTok. I don't know if anyone knows that. 17, like just all these other live streaming platforms that most marketers don't know about. Like most marketers know about Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, but not a lot of what Gen Z is using in terms of live streaming. And this platform will let you do all of that. So I get to geek out on it tomorrow.
Can everybody go live from their desktop on Instagram, or is that just rolling out and special people like you have access to it?
It's a new live streaming platform that I found out about. And I don't think a lot of people know, which is why I'm like, that is my premiere for tomorrow. It's like, I'm going to show you something new that I've been geeking out on. And Mike Lutton's been like geeking out with me too, because I'm like, how can we hack this? How can we hack this live streaming platform to be like a Be Live where I could have branded graphics and all that cool stuff? So I'm like super pumped to geek out about it. I think Eddie's going to be there. I think you're going to be there. And so is Mike. So right. Come out. I'm just going to show you my screen. Again,
what time is that? And where?
It's tomorrow. It's going to be on my Facebook page. So facebook.com, Hey Stephanie Liu. And it's going to be 2 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. If you guys can't hang out, that's okay. There's always going to be a replay. If you find the post, just leave the comment, subscribe, and then Robo Steph will come in and help you out. And P.S., by the way, like RoboCop. You remember RoboCop, right?
Absolutely.
Okay. Eddie, I hope, knows RoboCop. Some people were like, what's RoboSteph? And I was like, oh, do I have to like make the little glasses for you, the helmet? That's funny.
Oh, that's great.
I'm an 80s child.
Well, you were like one in the 80s?
No, I was.
I mean, I'm not good at math. But the reason why I went to practice law was because my parents said, you can be a doctor, you can be a lawyer, you can be a CPA. And I said, well, I hate science. I'm not good at math. So I'm a lawyer. And so one in the 80s, it sounds about right to me.
Have a nice day.
All right, we're going to tune in live tomorrow to find out all the ins and outs of how to do live from your desktop on Instagram. So tell me, what is Lights, Camera, Live all about?
Oh, okay. So, well, Lights, Camera, Live is a play off of Lights, Camera, Action, right? Because I was like, no, dude, I want to, okay. Every time you throw up Eddie's comments, I crack up.
I told you I was going to do a few things to sort of try to throw you off.
I know. I'm so red right now. I like match my lipstick. I love it though. Because it's, you know, it's all authentic. Lights, Camera, Live. Lights, Camera, Live. Lights is about stepping into the stoplight or stepping into the spotlight and taking your brand from unknown to unforgettable. And for a lot of people with live video, it's just about gaining that confidence. And so the program that I have is, let's get you camera confident. Camera is talking about what platform that you're going to use for your live streaming, what gear you need. And then live is actually going live and knowing that you're not going to go live by yourself, but you're going to have me there rooting for you. Like, let me tell you, I am the ultimate hype person in terms of getting people pumped up about live video. Like if you're ever just like, oh my God, I'm going to hit this like go live button and I'm totally scared out of my mind. Just imagine me saying like, you can do it. You can do it. Robo Steph says you could do it. Eddie says you could do it. Mike says you could do it. Brad, we're all cheering for you, you know? And so that's pretty much Lights, Camera, Live. It's this whole community of, we're going to launch a Facebook live show or on any other platform to take your brand from unknown to unforgettable.
And you have a website.
I do.
Lightscameralive.com. And you have a Facebook page?
I do. It's facebook.com/ Hey Stephanie Liu. But the best way, like if you guys want to just geek out with me more than twice a month, there's the Facebook group, which you're a part of, right? The Social Media Strategist group. And we have amazing people in there. Of course, you got your mics, you've got you, you've got Eddie, you've got Jen Herman in there. And they're just freely giving advice on how to knock it out of the park with social media. So if you guys want to hang out there, just type in your Facebook search box, type in social media strategist, and you'll see me. Yeah.
There you go. Stephanie Hype Girl Lou. How do you like that? Yes. Now you've got a new,
I like it.
Got a new name to a new label.
All about it.
I'm all about those labels. Oh, okay. Anything else that you can think of that would really be helpful for people, business owners in particular, to know about going live?
Yeah. Okay. I've worked with so many brands and they're used to working with creative agencies and having everything perfect, right? Like they're like, no. The lighting needs to be amazing. This needs to be perfect. We need to have the script down. Someone needs to be reading from a teleprompter. And let me tell you, the more polished you are, the more fake it feels, right? So if you are just your true authentic self, that's going to resonate more with your audience versus making it feel like a CNN production where it's like you have like a ticker running and like all this. It just feels weird. I don't know.
Yeah. So,
like, I'd say one of the best live episodes a client has was when her earring fell off and she's like, she was trying to read from the paper, like from the script, like, okay, I'm going to talk about this. And then her earring fell off and she's like, you know what? I can't do this. And she just threw it. She's like, whatever, I'm just going to ad lib this. And that was the best part because as soon as that happened, people were just like, cool, you're human. You're just like me. You're much more relatable. She made her brand completely just humanized as soon as she did that.
Yeah. See, I think that's a really important point to make that, you know, one of the beautiful things about live video is kind of the little speed bumps that get in your way. And those, I mean, people are still today talking about that video from the BBC reporter when the baby walked in. And I mean, that had to have been, I don't know, 2 years ago. And people are still talking about that because it was a real life thing that happens to me occasionally. Today, I sent my almost 8 month old 80 pound puppy to doggy daycare because last week, even though I put her in her kennel, I could hear her. You couldn't hear her, fortunately, because of the microphone that I use. But I could hear her whining in the other room. And so today I thought, oh, I'm not taking any chances. I'm sending her to doggy daycare today.
Oh, yeah. I was the same way. Like I usually have my teenager today. She's like, can you get me a snack? And I was like, iPad, go. But you know, I had to drop her off at grandma's house today. I was like, can you please watch her? It's just going to be an hour. All good.
Right. So where's the best place for people to connect with you of all the places that you are online?
I'd say the Facebook group. Honestly, the Facebook group, because that's where I don't have to worry about always going live. Like I'll just like post my favorite article that's in there. We could go back and forth. I have people just asking me about how to launch their live shows in as a post. And like, depending on what time of day you catch me, I might just like geek out for like 5 long paragraphs of like, all right, cool, Scott, this is what you're going to do. And like, it's just free advice. Like that's the best place to hang out.
Okay. We'll send people there. Mike Alton was kind enough to put the URL in a comment and I hope you're looking at that now and you're don't do it now. Wait, we're just about done. But as soon as we're done here in the next 30 seconds, run over there and join the group and then tell Stephanie that you learned about the group on Brad's Live.
Yeah.
Yeah. How do you like that? Let's see how many people do that. So Stephanie, thank you so much. I so appreciate you taking the time to drop value bomb after value bomb after value bomb, even while you're blushing a little.
Oh my God. I know. I was like, are you going to mention Eddie? Eddie, you know what? Now you're just going to be, every time your name pops up, I think I'm just like, oh.
Oh, I love Eddie. Oh my God. He was the best.
Dead. Yeah.
So really, no, thank you very much. And thank all of you for watching, whether you're here live or you're watching on the replay. Remember to like the Friedman Group Facebook page. And type live in the comments so that the Brad bot can let you know before we go live next. Next week. Oh, I'm excited about next week already. I've got Mitch Jackson joining me next week. Mitch is the live streaming lawyer. Mitch has a book coming out soon. We're going to be talking about that and a whole lot more. So I will be back next week. Same BAF time, same BAF channel, 5 o'clock Eastern. And until then, do something nice for someone else. Thanks. Yes.